Are you with them?
Yeah, we're all together.
No, we're not.
This is pictures.
Oh, pictures.
Oh. Two of you?
Yeah.
How many in your group? Two? Once they are done taking their picture, you can go right over to Stephanie in the pink and she can grab a quick photo for you.
Stephanie, I'm just taking in the middle and how are you today?
In 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
She said we can do a 4-3-1. Here we can take our own picture. Our visitors' clubhouse is no palace. Here, if you like.
Thank you.
Let's go down the second staircase there.
Sports Illustrated, the best place in all the country to watch a baseball game. If they had their choice, the writers of those magazines thought that they would love to sit here. So these are very special seats. And when the Red Sox first put these seats up here in 2003, they didn't know if they'd be popular. So they put them on sale for $50 a piece in February of 2003 during a blizzard. And people were so excited about them that they camped out in tents in front of the ticket office. When the ticket office opened, all 269 seats here on the Monster for all 81 home games, that's 21,000 seats, sold out in less than 72 minutes. So they knew they had something very special on their hands. And now people who sit up here really do have something special. If you have a ticket to come up here, no one else can come up here. There are no season tickets up here. And the reason for that is the Red Sox like to have as much turnover as possible to give as many people as possible the chance to be up here. You can come up early and watch batting practice. You have your own concession stands and your own bathrooms. So it's a very special opportunity. We tell people who have tickets for the Green Monster seats to be careful because balls come flying up here at 90 or 95 miles an hour. So we tell people to bring a glove or a hat or someone they don't like very much, anything to protect themselves from the ball. And we also have two nurses up here during the games in case people have not been paying attention. So if you'd like to take some pictures, please do so. Sometimes people ask me how much the tickets cost up here now. They're very expensive. They start at $165. We have what's called dynamic pricing, which means the price goes up and down like an airline ticket, and it depends on who we're playing, how they're doing, how we're doing, who's pitching, what the day of the week is, all sorts of factors. Yes, another question. What was the highest price? Well, up here, the highest price that was charged for a ticket was last September during Derek Jeter's last game, where the tickets went up to about $600 a piece. However, that does not include what tickets were selling for on the open market or with scalpers. There's one woman said to me, $600, and it doesn't even have a cushion. Okay, so if you can finish taking your pictures and follow me, we'll go up the stairs to our next stop.
The stairs to the ferry. that money cannot buy. You have to be a journalist to sit here. This is where the baseball writers sit. As you went down the hallway on the right, you may have noticed the broadcast booth where the radio and TV people were. We do have some more seats way up on the top there, or you can stand the landing seats. So we have 101 seats here. Should be enough for this group. Okay, so as you can see, we have four rows here, and all the seats are assigned. And they are assigned in order of seniority. The people in the first row are members of the Baseball Writers of America. They have to be elected to that organization. And those people decide not only on the Most Valuable Player and the Cy Young Award winner every year, they also decide whether or not to open these windows. These windows are huge, and it looks like they wouldn't open, but they do. And the writers like to have them open so they can feel and smell and hear the game, feel like they're more part of it. But they have to be careful because a lot of fly balls come up here. So on one end over here is where our official statistician sits. And on the other end by the other computer there is where the official scorekeeper sits. So I mentioned all the seats are in order of seniority. So we have four rows for the Baseball Writers of America, for local and regional press, and the visiting team press, and then up and up. And in the fourth row is where we put our Yankee writers. No, that's just, I'm just kidding. We had to add the fourth row because in 2007 we hired Daisuke Matsuzaka from Japan, and the Japanese love, love, love baseball. And so Daisuke arrived with no less than 150 press people. So that's why we added that fourth row. So from here, you can also look out and see the scoreboard very well, which is right underneath where we were sitting on the Green Monster. The scoreboard is one of the few manually operated scoreboards still left in Major League Baseball. It works just like a Little League scoreboard. So there are men behind the scoreboard with tiles, and the tiles have numbers on them, and they slide the tiles into those slots. One person does the Fenway Park scores, another does the American League scores, and a third does the National League scores. And those conditions behind the scoreboard where they work are the same as they were in 1934. There's no running water, there's no heat, there's no air conditioning, and there are no bathrooms. But the people who work back there love that job. And they've been there for a long time. They get into the area behind the scoreboard through a small door that you can just barely see. It's to the right of the words W.B. Mason and to the left of the words at bat. Does everyone see that? Can you see that? So another thing you can see clearly from here is our famous ladder. The ladder is directly above the door leading to the area behind the scoreboard. It's between the Foxwood sign and the Red Sox Scholar sign. That's the most useless ladder in the world. You may remember that I mentioned we had a net up on the top of the monster before we had our seats there. And when we had that net, the end of every game, one of the groundskeepers would attach a ladder to that ladder, climb up to the net, and get all the balls out of the net. When we put the seats on top, of course, we didn't need the ladder anymore. But because people in Boston love tradition, the Red Sox asked Major League Baseball if they could keep the ladder. So Major League Baseball said yes, and that ladder is in play, which means that any ball that hits that ladder, no matter how it bounces out afterwards, is in play, and the poor outfielders have to figure out which way it's going to go and run after it. So it can be very amusing, and it only happens once or twice a season that the ball hits that ladder. It doesn't get stuck behind it. So that's just a little quirk here at Fenway Park. So what we're going to do now is go out the same way we came in, and then head to the left and go down the first baseline, and we're going to go see the most famous seat in Fenway Park, which you can see quite clearly from here. If you look over toward the bleachers and you see that huge sea of green seats, you'll see one thing that sticks out that looks a little funny. Can anyone tell me what that might be? The red seat. That's right. And there's a wonderful story associated with the red seat. Does everybody see it? Okay, if you follow me this way, we will head over to the red seat.
Maybe that.
Yeah.
Someone's great grandfather just came into the game. That guy